The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention is sounding somewhat of an alarm. While the human papillomavirus, or HPV, vaccine has been proven to protect against cervical cancer and many others, not nearly enough girls are receiving it. To be specific, only 33% of teenage girls finished the required 3 doses of the vaccine in 2012. That means millions more are unprotected. The CDC reports in the U.S. more than 26,000 HPV-related cancers are diagnosed each year. About 17,400 of those cancers are identified in females, and more than 10,000 are cervical cancer. Cervical cancer is the second leading cancer killer of women in the world. But if all 3 doses are completed, the HPV vaccine can protect against virus strains connected to 70% of cervical cancers. So what's keeping kids from being vaccinated? A CBS contributor blames doctors.
Most doctors, or many doctors, aren't telling parents, listen, this is a vaccine we need to do. The data are there, it works. But, you know, there is fear about vaccines that's inappropriate, and doctors aren't pushing hard enough.
But the NBC chief medical editor says there's a wide misconception about the vaccine.
This is not a pro-you-can-have-sex vaccine. This is an anti-cancer vaccine. And the sooner we wrap our heads around that, the better we make public health.
Many have urged for the vaccine to be added to the required vaccination list for public schools. Take, for example, Texas Governor Rick Perry, who in 2007 made an executive order to require all 6th grade girls in the state to receive the vaccine unless their parents opted out. NPR points out the mandate was quickly overturned, but Perry was widely criticized for making it. Former Pennsylvania Senator Rick Santorum described the order as having little girls inoculated at the force and compulsion of the government. Today, school districts in Virginia and Washington do require kids to have the vaccine. The CDC recommends both boys and girls get vaccinated between the ages of 11 and 12 before they are likely to become sexually active. For Newsy, I'm Jasmine Bailey.